Earl created a team around Tiger. John Anselmo, a pro at Meadowbank Golf Course in Huntington Beach, was the first recruit.
I had never seen actually a child with that much ability with a golf swing at that age. I've seen many kids in my life which I've taught, but this one possessed such a great rhythm and instinct for the game. And the surprising thing about Tiger was that he was very positive about what he was trying to do. He was practicing hard then and just kept doing it for years. So what I saw in Tiger was a good future. It's hard to believe when you look at a young child, but that one possessed so much inner talent and control that I was amazed. And he just practiced all the time. He practiced at night. He'd be putting at night on a putting green when he was growing up. So he was just dedicated, what you want to call it. He wanted to achieve something.
Jay Brunza, a captain in the U.S. Navy and a San Diego psychologist, completed the team in 1989.
Jay, at the time, we didn't know he was even a psychologist. I just knew him as Jay. And then we'd play golf with him every Saturday. He'd drive up from San Diego and we'd play golf. And that was the end of it. And we just had a great time. And he was a good golfer.
It all started out as kind of a social event. They knew I was a naval officer, no idea what my background and training was at that time.
Well, I started getting a little older and we started talking about it more, and he was a psychologist, and what he would do with you know, kids, especially child psychologists, to these kids with cancers and other debilitating diseases, and he'd help them out mentally. So I wonder if that could help me.
Earl asked me if I would be willing to work with Tiger, and he wanted Tiger to have the advantage of a lot of the young kids at that time that were hooked up with you know, physical trainers, sports psychologists, and people like that. And I felt that I had enough background and experience because I knew that was a remarkable talent.
When I was a kid, I never thought I had the talent. I never thought I had the gifts to play the game. I knew I had a little bit to compete. But I thought my biggest edge is I wanted to beat you.
The killer instinct, either you have it or you don't. When he was young and I see that he got the killer instinct, I encourage him. I try to tell him this, when you are ahead, you got to finish it off.
On a stretch and knowing the fact that I kicked everybody's butt. That to me is fun.
That's the way it's supposed to be. When it's over, okay, we are friends. But when in that time in the sport, the competition, you have to do it.
There's no There's no feeling that I've found so far that matches the feeling of knowing that I've beaten everybody. It's just, you know, everyone has the same opportunity. It's just that, you know, I've come out on top. And that is, knowing all the hard work and preparation that goes into just one victory, which is what makes it so satisfying. To step on their throat. That's just part of it. And in order to, there's nothing wrong with being, you have to be gracious, you have to be respectful. But the attitude that you have to bring to the table is one of, you know, I'm going to win. And what's second place? Second place is first loser. So, you know, winning is everything. And that's how I look at it. You know, I love to win. And I just can't stand finishing second.
Like my words too much.
By 14, Tiger hadn't come second very often.
What you got there?
8. No shot.
Cut.
Of the 400 plus tournaments he had played, he had won 260. He had made 3 holes in one and was preparing for his 4th junior world title with Jay Brunza.
When I come down and stay with him at the junior world championships, we do some sessions. It was pretty cool of how it helped me understand a different part of my creativity.
Tiger was tremendous because he has such a gifted creative imagination.
But I could never control it. I mean, I couldn't fathom someone saying, you know, visualize a golf shot. Well, I see this ball going every which way. My creative mind would never see me a golf shot doing this or doing this. My mind would not let me to do that. It'd see it going all over the place. So he said, "Why don't you just feel it? Use your hands, use your fingers, use your body awareness to harness your creativity that way, and come up with an answer." And he was very instrumental in teaching me how to control my creative mind.
I sort of used to chuckle when everybody would say, "Oh, wow, that Tiger, he hits it so far," and I'd sort of gently say, "Well, he does. He's long off the tee, and he's got a great power game." I said, "But the genius of Tiger Woods is his creative imagination in the short game."